Let's compare Windows 11 22H2 with Windows 11 RTM. On the left we have Windows 11 RTM build 22000.192, which was released on the 5th of October 2021, and on the right we have Windows 11 22H2 build 22621.521, which was released on the 20th of September 2022. In Windows 11 RTM the title bars of Win32 apps are solid white, in Windows 11 22H2 they are mica when active and light gray when inactive. This is also true on old third-party programs. If you disabled transparency effects, the title bar of both active and inactive apps will be light gray. They both have the option to show the accent color on the title bar, and if you enable it the active title bar will look the same in both, but in RTM the inactive title bar will be white and in 22H2 it will be light gray. In RTM the widgets button on the taskbar is in between the task view and chat, and it has an icon and there is nothing at the left of the taskbar. In 22H2 the widgets button is at the left of the taskbar and it shows the weather on it. In 22H2 if you left align the taskbar icons the widgets button will be in between the task view and chat like it is in RTM, but it will still show the weather rather than an icon. In 22H2 you can drag and drop icons onto the taskbar to pan them, in RTM you cannot. In 22H2 you can drag and drop start menu icons onto each other to make folders which you can name. In RTM you cannot. In 22H2 when you right-click on the start menu you get start settings, in RTM you get nothing. In 22H2 the start menu can have 3 rows of icons and 3 rows of recommendations, 2 rows of icons and 4 rows of recommendations, or 4 rows of icons and 1 row of recommendations. In RTM it can only have 3 rows of icons and 3 rows of recommendations. In 22H2 Windows Ease of Access has been renamed to Accessibility. The icons for on-screen keyboard and magnifier have been updated. In RTM the power menu options are sleep, shutdown and restart. In 22H2 it also has sign-in options as well. In 22H2 in the menu that you get when you right-click the start button apps and features has been renamed to installed apps and Windows Terminal has been renamed to Terminal. In RTM the volume changing UI looks the same as it does in Windows 8 and 10. In 22H2 it has been updated. In RTM when you click the accessibility button on the login screen the menu is white with square corners like it is in Windows 10. In 22H2 the menu is dark and has rounded corners and the options have icons which they don't in RTM. In 22H2 the default profile picture has been updated. Let's compare Task Manager. In RTM the tabs are along the top and they have a name with no icon, in 22H2 they are down the left and have an icon with no name and the name comes up when you hold the mouse over them. There is a hamburger button at the top left which brings up the names next to the icons if the window is wide enough. In RTM the highlight around the numbers is orange, in 22H2 it is the accent color. In RTM in dark mode Task Manager is still light, in 22H2 in dark mode Task Manager is dark. In RTM the options are under the options menu, in 22H2 there is a settings button in the bottom left which brings up the settings page. In RTM under the file menu there is an option to run new task. In 22H2 there is a Run New Task button. In 22H2, Notepad has been updated. In 22H2 to change the font you go to the Settings icon in the top right, in RTM you go to Format and then Font. In RTM in dark mode Notepad is still light, in 22H2 in dark mode Notepad is dark. In 22H2 the Print dialog has been updated, even when printing from a Win32 application. In both RTM and 22H2. When you hold the mouse over the maximize button it gives you snapping options. In 22H2 when you start dragging a window it comes up with a thing at the top and when you drag the window onto that thing it gives you snapping options. In RTM it does not. You can snap windows by dragging them to the edge of the screen in both. In RTM the Alt+Tab switcher is full screen with a blurry background. In 22H2 the Alt+Tab switcher is in a window with a blurry background. In RTM when using multiple monitors the clock is only on the main screen. In 22H2 the clock is on all screens, however the notifications are only on the main screen and only clicking the clock on the main screen brings up the calendar and notifications. Clicking the clock on the second screen does nothing. In 22H2 Quick Access has been renamed to Home. In RTM the File Explorer can either be set to open to Quick Access or this PC. In 22H2 it can also be set to open to OneDrive. In 22H2 at the top of the date and time page of the settings app it now has a clock. In RTM, if you maximize the settings app on a screen that is 1920 pixels wide with the scale at 100%, the contents is left aligned with empty space at the right. In 22:2, the contents is centered with empty space at both sides. In 22:2, there is now a new accessibility tool called Live Captions, which will automatically generate captions for any audio the computer is playing. The live captions can be docked to the top or bottom of the screen or floating in a window. It can also caption microphone audio. You can also change the color and style of the text. In RTM, the loading circle on the boot screen is circling dots. In 22:2, it is a circling line. Goodbye.